Hello, you guys. So I was sitting here shuffling these cards and my phone had quit. So I've done got a few messages out. I was going to get another one or two. And then we'll read this. If you're new to my channel, please hit subscribe. If you feel my vibe. This is Pam's Star Oracle. I like to read Oracle cards. And I appreciate each and every one of y'all who helps me, okay? I appreciate you all so much. You know what? I'm grateful to you all. And I hope you all will get your dream life and get up and do it every day. What you're wanting to accomplish and your dreams will come true. Okay, babies. Oh, God, you're going to get a good message here now. I can tell you right now. I can done tell. I see Divine Masculine, Divine Feminine. Oh, wow. And let's see what they say. We'll mix these up a little, okay? Oh, wow. I seen you. Twin flame. Ooh. Twin flames, you know, this feels like you're dating yourself. And life will change dramatically when you meet your twin flame. If your life has changed totally from meeting this one person, well, that's your twin. Oh, yeah. And you're all going through you might have had a Kundalini awakening together, okay? And your spiritual awakening together. Ooh. And you have telepathy. Twin flame, I love you. Oh, you know who it is. And you all mirror each other. You compliment each other. And if one of you's feeling shitty about yourself, the other is going to feel shitty. 202, whatever it's going on right now in your life, the other one's already experienced it or is experiencing it the same, you know. And that's just how it is. But you feel an intense, tight bond with this person. You can't let them go because you experience soul recognition. That's why. 222, I love you, twin flames. Did you see that? I love you. I'm a starseed. I have a twin flame, yeah. And Divine Masculine wants to steal you away and for you to move in with him. Oh, Divine Masculine, he wants you, baby. He wants you to move in with him, and that's your twin flame. And he's telling you that all this hard work has really paid off. He sees all the hard work you've been put in, and he loves you so much. Twin flame, he can't believe it, and he loves when y'all talk in your brains. He knows that you all, there's never been another person like you, and he wants to take you on a cruise ship. Look, remember Monopoly? I couldn't find the game, but I kept all them little things. Excuse me. Yeah, I couldn't find the board game because my boys, they lost the board game, but I put that little money bag up there. So don't you worry, Divine Masculine. We're going to get us some money bags. And can I show y'all what I found the other day? I told you. Now, I found this yesterday, Sunday. Look how pretty it is. It's like such... Look how pretty it is. I've never seen, and you know them little birds that look like roadrunners, and if you look at them, they'll go, shh, their wings will do this. They look brown and white, and then they look gray and white. I believe it come from that bird, and I love that bird, them birds that come to my house, but look how pretty it is. And I said, I love you, spirit, because I have never seen such a beautiful feather. Look at it. And I wanted to show y'all that, and I found this between 703 and 704, so you'll have to look up them numbers, and you might have a message in there since I found it, and Spirit told me to show it to you, and I put it on my little angel right there. Yes, that's messages from heaven now, I'm telling you. All right, and it says, hit me with your best shot. Why don't you hit me with your best shot? Hit me with your best shot. Fire away. I don't remember who sings that song. Oh, baby, I do. I love rock and roll. It's that woman. I can't think of her name. But it's telling you to not let your life pass you by. Why do you just keep sitting and waiting and waiting and waiting on that person? Just letting her, and your life's passing you by. You're not even going towards your twin flame. And my masculine is saying, divine feminine, when are you coming to see me? And it says right here, divine feminine is coming to see you, divine masculine, sometime this week. She's not going to let this pass her by. And divine masculine said, I want to taste you, divine feminine. Oh, wow. I'm going to put you right under your divine masculine. He wants to taste you and lick you. He's saying, I miss my intellectual match. You and your twin are very smart. That's all I can say. And I can tell you what, he is solid as a rock for you, baby. Your twin flame is 606 is solid as a rock for you. He only wants you, and he don't want lust energy, and they want to watch porn and snort cocaine. Oh, did you hear that, twin? It told on our friend man, didn't it? Our friend man's, and maybe our mates, our old mates. Hang on a minute. Maybe Divine Masculine wants to watch porn with you, snort coke, but I don't think so because y'all not supposed to do meanest together, okay? That'd be your fake twin wants to do that. And you need to go towards the person who has it all together, twin flame. And they want to lick you up and down, baby. I told you, they want to taste you and they want to lick you, divine feminine, divine masculine. Both of you all want to eat each other and lick each other because the angel of love is at work for you all. See? That's what it is. Thank you for this message, spirit. I love you. I thank you for this message that I got today. And during a super moon in Aquarius, which is in August 722, I think it's in August or September, but it brings you into your life purpose, baby, blue, blam. What do you think about that, divine masculine twin? And it says, my angels are leading me, 737, twin flame number, look it up, are leading me to you, divine masculine. My angels are leading me to you, divine masculine. See? The angels is doing it. You know they are. Now, come on, buddy. Somebody wants to hit you with their best shot and try to bring some cocaine and snort with you and watch porn. And that's not hard work. Hard work is not doing that. That's easy to go buy drugs and fuck. Ain't it? Ain't that easy? 808, 809, ain't that easy? And see ya, wouldn't want to be ya. That's what you're telling this person that wants to go take you to a motel and fuck you and snort drugs. And this person feels so damn lost without you. They know you've pulled your energy away. Even if you're living with them, they can feel 828-829. They can feel when your energy ain't with them. Are you listening? It's true. And let's go skinny dipping. Oh, wow. Twin flame wants to go skinny dipping. And he's saying to you, and you're saying to him, stop the old patterns with this past life karmic, divine masculine, divine feminine. Stop with the karmic. If you've learned many, many lessons, you're supposed to leave that person. Are you understanding what past life karmics are? Okay. I hope you're all learning what it means. But now remember that super moon that's in Aquarius. In Aquarius are very inventive people, but you need to be aware of that energy because don't let that energy go to waste. And the full moons is usually around the middle, 9/19, the middle of the month, from the 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th, you know, around an hour. But I should have. But remember, don't let life pass you by. Divine Feminine's coming to see you, Divine Masculine, this week. She's going towards the person who has it all together because Angel of Love is telling her to. And she knows that Divine Masculine wants her. She knows this. And it says, He wants to taste you, Divine Feminine. He wants to take you skinny dipping, and he wants to lick you up and down because angels is leading him to you and to her. Divine Masculine and Divine Feminine, it's your angels, and they miss their intellectual match. They know you're all supposed to build together and build a solid as rock life, baby, for you is what it says. And he sees all his hard work has paid off, and they love you. And he sees that you stopped these old patterns with this past life karmic, and he sees that your old person is lost, is going to be feeling so damn lost without you, and they know that you're going to say, see, you wouldn't want to be you because they're in lust energy all the time. They just want to fuck and do drugs, and we're saying, hit me with your best shot. Fucking leave today. If you're strong, that's what you need to do. I'm telling you. Aquarius is out there. I'm telling you. Because they love only you. They love only you. And that old divine, that old masculine of yours, they sit back and watch you and stalk you. They don't care for you. 1111, I love you, twin flame. They don't care for you. They don't want nobody to look at you. You're not allowed to work. You're not allowed to have friends. Not allowed to have a man friend that was probably trying to help you, your business to grow, and you can't even have that. But that's all right. We know who twins are, don't we? Woo. We know who that twin is. We all do. We all know who our twin is, and they can't take that from you, so don't worry. So, can we have an oracle message today for my collective? And please help me get my name around. Please hit subscribe right now if you're new, please. Because I'll give you a good message. Don't you worry, baby. And I tell you right now, you're getting animal energy and power sent to you at the moment. If there's a lot of animals coming around you, they're guiding you to leave that damn situation. And they're all around my house. And number 27 is special. That's when my brother died. And this could be, you know, this is about your expansion of your legacy. Maybe you've already had a family before and you got a family tree with this person and you're meant to have another family legacy. See it, little baby? Maybe you're meant to have a little baby with somebody else. And the animals is trying to lead you to that. They're like, go towards your legacy. You're getting power sent to you to do this. Because that's the only way your heart's going to heal. The healing heart, number 9. Maybe your life path, number 9. But, you know, this is about a love, acceptance, and romance. That is what you need. You need to accept this love and this new romance. Because it's leading you to what you need. Because both of you all feel a kinship. Like, you're all in... You're going to be in a community together in your group. Like, maybe the animals and angel powers is bringing this community in your group. Like, for me, I love y'all and I thank you, 1313. And that means 44s. If you see 44 is a lot. And I got my angels, I'll read in a minute. And, you know, your spirit's bringing my spiritual community for me. And I love you for that. And I hope I can be of help to you all. And I hope you all help get my name around in this community, 1333. Because, you know, if you're like me, yes, I've linked my lineage back to Bible days. I've talked about it on my channel. You'll just have to watch them videos. But, you know, this is about prophets and ancient seers. And, you know, and yes, my lineage links back to that. And I can't wait to talk to my Divine Masculine about it. And them and actually believe me and not believe me, because it's kind of like that energy right now I'm feeling. But you got decisions about this predictive guidance. If you're being guided to someone, go to them. What's it going to hurt? 1 + 8 = 9, 18 up there. See prophets and ancient seers. It fucking all connects back. Do you get it yet? 8 + 1 = 9. 1 + 8 = 9. And I'm a life path 9 number. See that? And 27 is a number. Is 8's one of their favorite numbers, like their numbers they follow. I know, because I've done studied up on all this, man. Man, do you get it yet, man? You need to get it yet, man. Oh, and these cards right here about King Arthur and stuff. I watched something on history the other day about King Arthur and Guinevere. And it was that one man. What is his name? That old man off Star Trek, that show that I watched. But they was saying that some people believe that, you know, because it's supposed to be, you know, like, it's just a made-up story, a fairy tale about Arthur and the Knight of the Rounds, the Knights at the Round Table. But then they actually found this big place where it looks round, and, like, people actually went there and did their, you know, whenever they got together in their community, them men that did that. And the thing is that Arthur is said to be, they think that he'll come back to life, 1555, I just saw. And maybe somebody out here is linked to King Arthur, because King Arthur was said to have found the Holy Grail. And the Holy Grail is what Joshua packed, yeah, in the Bible. Yeah, uh-huh. And I link my lineage to that. And I thought that was amazing, because Spirit told me to buy these cards and I didn't even know it. And I watched it over the weekend and it was just amazing. And it's called The Unexplained. Watch that show on History Channel and it'll be about Arthur. It's got a bunch of good stuff on it and about Jesus and a bunch of different stuff and science. And it had a new human that they had found. And you know what the name was? You know what the name was, Divine Masculine? Denny Von. D-E-N-N-I-V-O-N. And my last name, well, you know, so there it is. And I just wanted to tell you, in 1655, I just saw, and I thought that was amazing. Now, what do y'all think about that shit, man? So, what about Animal Totem? What about Animal Totem? Oh, wow. Oh, gosh. You're getting these powers to go towards your sacred union. See, I told you. I told you that's what it was. And, you know, you're growing, you know. This is about being fertile at the moment. And you're feeling all that vitality. And them big buck deers. Look at this man. It's like he's got tree deer horns. See it coming out of his head right here. It's leading you to your divine masculine, okay? That's what it is. This is about sexual energy going towards, and look at this, and looky here, look, see them deer horns, see how Spirit shows, he says, pay attention, I'm gonna show you all these cards, something, okay, so that's what that means. And what about family tree, expansion, legacy? Oh, wow, we got Blutawed, and this is about, you're going through renewal at the moment. Your body is feeling purified and you're very authentic and people love you because you're just a free type of individual. And you probably see 33s a lot, and when you do, that's your manifestation powers, okay, baby? And you need to remember that. And you might have a little owl that comes around you. I'd love to have a white owl as a pet. I would love that so. Oh, wow, and I do have a pet that comes around my house, and it comes around my tree right at my front door where I, in here at my, when I'm doing dishes and cooking supper, I see him at the evening time. What about healing heart, spirit, love, acceptance, romance? Ooh, Morgan Le Fay said, you better use your intuition about this romantic partner, because, you're fated to meet this person, and maybe someone could have did magic on you, it's saying right now, but I don't think so. It just feels kind of magical, because, you know, this is something you saw, you know, prophecy. You saw this in advance. You saw this with one look with this person, huh? You know, this is healing your heart from all this, and it could be healing your heart from all this magic that they sent towards you. I mean, because a lot of people has to do that, I'm telling you right now. They had to deal with that magic shit, and I'm not lying either. Excuse me. What else is it that Aquarius needs to know? Kinship or somebody inquiring on Aquarius needs to know. Yeah, you can look at my channel for Aquarius, or if you love an Aquarius, you can watch this, okay? And even if you're not, you'll find a message in here. So, I mean, just watch it. And kinship, you're feeling in your community. This is from the ethereal realms at the moment, okay? This is like an everlasting bond that you have with this group of people. And you're all on a journey, and you're in this new rebirth at the moment. And you're just loving every little, you're connecting every little dot. And you might be a magical unicorn, and it says the other world, you know? Because you can, you're going to go journey to this other world. You want to ascend back, okay? Maybe they see you as a magical unicorn, and they feel a kinship with you. What about prophets and ancient seers? Oh, looky here. What was I said about King Arthur? Now look, and I just saw 2055 about 3 seconds ago. This is about you having the power and the authority to bring about this justice in your own lives at the moment, because it says it says leadership. So you're a powerful being. Don't think you're not. I mean, if you're like me and you're just getting started out, 21-21, you might feel like 33 manifestation, you know. You might feel like you're not getting anywhere or nothing. And like I said, I need help. I need y'all's help with subscriptions. I'm not asking for money. I mean, I'm not doing no personal readings. I'm not asking for that. I'm just asking for a little subscribe and a like. And you don't have to watch me every day. Just scroll down. That's all you gotta do. I love y'all. And you always come back and get a message from me. That's what I'm trying to say. Because, yes, I've seen a lot of visions and things. And you gotta watch my videos and you'll hear me talk about it. Because I don't have time to talk about that every day. You know what I mean? And I know one thing, that there is a prophet. And it is linked to King Arthur, and King Arthur was not fake. I think people's realizing now that, oh wow, Spirit, I love you, looky, oh wow, looky, the Holy Grail. King Arthur was real, and this is a sacred union. And I'm telling you right now, you got to use your wisdom, because you're getting regeneration at the moment, like, from life forces coming into you. You know, Jesus's blood was in the Holy Grail. They went over and caught blood in it. Remember when they had him on the cross? But, you know, this is about your spirit. This is about your spirit. You're healing your heart and spirit, because you know you have a divine mask on that. I done told you that's linked to the Joshua. And you know how powerful you are? You know how powerful that we are? Get into the program and quit running from it. We can rule the world, babies. Did you hear that? Oh, yeah. You surely can. I'm trying to find another little message to give you all. Okay? What else does Aquarius need to know, or people inquiring on Aquarius need to know? You're getting powers from your animal spirits, because they're trying to bring you into this sexual energy to go towards your divine, your sacred union. And, oh gosh, intense. It says the intensity of a true soul connection includes great highs and great lows. Boy, ain't that true. Buddy, it does. In any relationship, a true soul connection, you'll have highs and you'll have lows. It's not going to be always unicorns and fairyland. No, and what about you're studying your family tree? Maybe you're expanding your legacy at the moment, and you're manifesting your dream life. What about you're manifesting your dream life? You're manifesting your true love, and true love comes when you least expect it. 24-22, baby. 24-24. Oh, baby. That's why. It comes when you least expect it, and you're healing your heart, and you're accepting this new romance. And Morgan Le Fay says, you know, you're a prophet. You prophesize, and you're a magical person. You're fated to do this. Use your intuition. You're fated to be a person that helps others. So cherish your relationship and cherish that you've healed your heart. Cherish that you're a magical being, okay? This intense true love, cherish it. It's kinship, you know, and this is about your community, and you're all going through a rebirth at the moment, and you could be meeting up in the ethereal realms at the moment, the ethers, you know. You're getting advice from the ethers, that's what it is, and you have this everlasting love on your journey to rebirth. Signs. This is what you're getting, signs. Watch out for signs leading you to your true love. Boy, ain't that true. You got a kinship in your community. Watch for the signs it's leading you to true love. So somebody that's in your community you're in love with, and it's this ancient seer or prophet that, you know, was probably also King Arthur, and they don't know it. And what else? What else about King Arthur? This leader in the community. What else about him? And King Arthur is number 19 over here, it says. What about King Arthur? Spirit said. Connection. Your connection is eternal and unbreakable. It's eternal, 2616. Meaning it's lasted forever and ever. Nobody can break it. They can try, honey, but they're not going to. So don't worry. They can't break this connection. This intense true love, cherish the signs and this connection, baby. Cherish it. It's telling you, don't let it go. Do not let it slip through your little fingers, okay? And now I'm wanting to get one more. And this one fell out. You're going to have sudden wealth. Sudden wealth. You got a wealth of spiritual cause that Holy Grail. Who is it, Spirit? What is the message we need to know today? Whose it might be pertaining to? Saturn. Ooh, you got a little Aquarius energy or Capricorn. This is about the maturity that brings awareness. And it'll, you know, caution regarding limits imposed. Maybe you've put some self-imposed limits on yourself, Saturn, and you need to stop doing that. And you need to be realistic about some things in your life and be concerned about, you know, how you show up in this world. And it said, you must wait before you can. So, it said, Saturn, you must wait before you can do something, okay? But you're mature and you know what that means, all right? Oh, wow, because you're a person of high honor, number 25. That's why. Somebody loves you big. If your birthday's number 25, Aquarius, 125, somebody loves you big. Oh, wow. Shout out if your birthday's 125, Aquarius. Woo-woo. Oh, and you better cherish. You're healing this heart, and you're cherishing your relationship, and you're cherishing your marriage. This is for somebody that's married out there. You're high honors in your marriage. Bye, bye, bloom, blam, and the community sees it. And they see it. You get a lot of signs from the divine, and they know that it's your true love. Your true love is coming in the distant horizons, baby, bloom, blam, it said. And this prophet and ancient seer, it's connected to King Arthur, is an eternal connection. 2828 is your eternal connection, is eternal and unbreakable. And that means 10-10 giant blessings. I told you, sudden success. Woo, sudden wealth. Oh, wow. This ancient prophet wants to court somebody out here. Oh, wow. He wants to marry you. Look what it said underneath this. Hang on. It said, be realistic about this intense true love of high honor. Cherish your relationship and your marriage and the signs of true love that's coming to you in the distant horizons, because this connection is eternal and unbreakable, and they're going to want to court you. Who wants to court? 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 Oh, wow. Hang on a minute. It said, somebody that you wanted to court might have been in despair. And it could have been a Virgo because they got a full-time job and they don't get to see you much or something. It could be that. Maybe y'all don't get to connect as much as you used to did. But maybe it's maybe this just means that you're doing service to others. That's what it means. And it's telling you to do what is good for you because your work is bringing you a great fortune, okay? Oh, that's what it means. Oh, wow. I'll tell you who else is, who wants you to change? Aries. Look here. Aries is telling you, you know who the hell you are. This is about your desires and your actions. You need to do this immediately. And the way you project yourself is towards maybe this Aries. And it says, do it on your own. Do it on your own, this change. You know who you are. Do it on your own, this change. Because, you know, you got Mars energy here helping to energize you and helping you to confront those inner issues that you're scared to confront. Force yourself to confront the sumbitches. Now, you got to get real and force yourself to do the right work, okay? Because you got the drive for this success and you're confronting. You're getting ready to confront this person that you needed to confront so you could move and change towards the person that you love truly, that you're supposed to be married to. That's what it said. So, okay. So, this reading was for Aquarius, for Aries. Yeah, that's what it was for, because that was just meaning work over at Virgo. But, oh, wow. This is a mature man, it says. Mature man understands your dreams and your ideas as a part of something overwhelmingly big, and they understand, and they're opening up to their spirituality at the moment, and they're actually, and it says Taurus right here, it's telling you to use your most direct way to go confront this person, because they love you and they're wanting to talk about your beliefs with you. Bloom blam, baby. 3155. I love y'all. Go ahead and hit subscribe. If you watch it all the way to the end, please hit subscribe. Do the right thing. I love you, and I hope I helped you out tremendously here at Pound Star Oracle. And go over and hit my little face picture hit my little face picture and hit videos, and you can watch all my videos. I love y'all. And if you want to send me a donation or something, my info is on my about page at Pound Star Oracle, okay? Because somebody fucks with my channel every day, and I need a new computer, and I don't have one yet. And I love y'all, in peace, and I'll see you later. I hope I could just help at least 1 or 10 or 50 of you out there. I need the help to get around. Thank you.